the different drugs. So Nigantus accepted that Bijaka and Asana are one and the same, but they are different. Okay, nowadays the recent the botanist, they have described both the different the characters of the morphological characters, the botanical sources, and even the family. They have mentioned in detail about Bijaka and Asana. Okay, so Bijaka is a Pterocarpus marsupium, which is belongs to the Fabaceae family, whereas Asana is a Terminalia tomentosa. Okay, so both are entirely different drugs. During the Nigantu period, its utility has increased. At present, it is one of the potent anti-diabetic drug. In the examination, it may be in the theory examination or it may be in the vibobasi. So if the examiner asked about Bijaka or Asana, so you can mention about its the karma or the practical utility. So you have to mention about it is one of the potent anti-diabetic drug. It is one of the potent anti-diabetic drug like Vijaya Sara, Asana Adi Kashaya. So these are the some of the very well known the products nowadays we are using for the prameha conditions. Okay, so the basonym of Bijaka. Phale Bija Shaiva Pradhanyat. See the name Bijaka, what it denotes. So maybe that is the predominant part in the fruit is seed. So I will show some picture and I will explain. That is in the first slide itself. So this is just 1 minute. So this is the fruit. This is the fruit of Bijaka. So these are all the fruits of Bijaka. Where, so usually epicarp, mesocarp, endocarp, like we used to describe about the parts of the fruit. But here seed will be predominant, only seed. And this is about almost like the winged wings, like that epicarp. It is a small skin like layer will be present. So there is no other any the parts. Only the predominant part will be the seed. Here, what you are observing in this picture, this is the seed which is enclosed by a leathery layer. That is Bija Shaiva Pradhanyo. So Bija will be the predominant. So Phale Bija Shaiva Pradhanyat. In the fruit, seed will be predominant. So there is no mesocarp, there is no like the endocarp, such type the part. It will not be present. Only the seed will be present. The seed will be covered by a leathery layer like structures. Okay, that's why they used to call it as Bijaka. Okay, you come back the meaning of Bijaka. Okay, seed appears prominent in a fruit. That is the basonym of Bijaka. Next, we'll move to the botanical source, the botanical name of Bijaka. That is Pterocarpus marsupium. Pterocarpus marsupium. So already we come across with this the genus Pterocarpus while discussing about Rakta Chandana. Okay, so Rakta Chandana, that is Pterocarpus santalinus. Here we are discussing about Bijaka, that is Pterocarpus marsupium. Both are belongs to the Fabaceae family. So the Pterocarpus, there also we have discussed. Pteron means like wing. Pteron, P-T-E-R, pteron means wing. Carpus means like nut or the fruit. The fruits are winged fruits will be present. The fruits are winged. That is called as Pterocarpus and marsupium and belongs to the family Fabaceae family, that is Shimbicula. Okay. Now we'll move to the vernacular names. In English, it is called Indian Kino tree. Indian Kino tree. So you may get in neat examination. Which drug is called as Indian Kino tree? Which drug is called as Indian Kino tree? Like Bijaka, Asana, or any other the two drugs they may give. So Indian Kino tree is Bijaka. Indian Kino tree is Bijaka. Kannadalli Hannemara. In Kannada it is called as Hannemara. In Hindi it is called Vijayasar. Hindi ali Vijayasar. Okay. Next we'll move to the Ganas. According to Charaka, it is mentioned under Udardha Prashamana Mahakashaya. Udardha Prashamana Mahakashaya. And according to Shishruta, Salasaradigana. So already we have discussed about udardha prashamana mahakashaya. Okay, just we'll recollect what is meant by udardha. Udardha prashamana mahakashaya. So udardha is a type of shita pitta. Already I think you come across with this disease in the Roga Nidhana. In Roga Nidhana paper 2, while discussing about the diseases, a type of shita pitta, that is shita pitta, udardha, kota. So udardha we used to consider, it is a type of shita pitta. So this udardha is a predominant, this is a tridosha janya vyadi. Udardha is a tridosha janya vyadi. Mainly it is having the predominance of kapha dosha will be predominant. Even though it is having tridosha, the predominant in that, mainly kapha will be predominant. So what are the some of the symptoms they used to occur in case of udardha? So in case of udardha, there will be a khandu will be present. Along with that khandu, that is udardho varati damstrakaraha shotaha samshamanam udardha prashamanam. What they used to define, Acharya Gangadhara, even the Chakrapani, while commenting on Charaka Sutras, the fourth chapter, that is Shadvirechana Shatashiddhi Adhyaya. So Chakrapani and Gangadhara, he used to comment on that udardha prashamana mahakashaya. He used to say, udardho varati damstrakaraha shotaha prashamanam udardha prashamanam. Varati damstrakaraha shotaha, a type of insects, that is varati damstrakara, when some the insect they used to bite. So immediately after the biting, that insect, it produces the shota in that particular part. So such type of shota will be present in case of udardha. Such type of the shota will be present. How they used to compare in udardha, which type of the shota will be present? The shota which is present in udardha is as like that of varatidam strakaraha, when the insect they used to bite. So at that time, the shota is going to be produced. In the same way, that type of shota will be present in case of udardha. So the drugs which reduces that shota, those drugs are called as udardha prashamana mahakashayas, udardha prashamana dravyas. Okay, so the drugs one which reduces the shota and also reduces the, that is, they used to say anti-urticarial drugs. The drugs one which reduces the shota along with that the urticaria, that is the itching sensation. So such type of drugs, they used to call it as udardha prashamana dravyas. Okay, so as udardha is a type of shita pitta, which is a tridosha janya vyadi, mainly it is having the kapha dosha will be predominant. So udardha prashamana dravyas are tridosha shamaka or kapha shamaka dravyas. So what may be the, what are the dravyas which are belongs to the which does udardha prashamana karma? That is sindukha. I think we have seen in the Kapadugudda, sindukha, priyala, sindukha, priyala, badara, kadira, kadara, badara, kadira, kadara, ashvakarana, ashvakarana, and Arjuna, Arimeda. So these are the drugs. Sindukha, Priyala, Badara, Kadira, Kadhara, Ashvakarana, then Arimeda, Arjuna, Asana. So these are the 10 drugs which are having or which are useful in case of to treat the conditions like udardha. Okay, so already that is while discussing about Arjuna, the drug we have discussed, this Mahakashaya. Okay, so this Tindukha, that is Bryophyrus embryoteris, Bryophyrus embryoteris, that is belongs to the Ebensia family. I think I have discussed while discussing about Kupilo also. There are some of the synonyms are like they would compare with this Tindukha fruit. Tindukha, Kaka Tindukha, Piluka, Kaka Piluka, there we have discussed also this drug, Tindukha. So Tindukha fruit mainly, so that is everted, the calyx will be everted, and the fruits of Tindukha is resembles as like that of even the Kupilu. Same, the resemblance, the color. Okay, Tindukha, Priyala, and see, Badara, Kadira, Kadara. So Badara, that is Jujubas Jejuba, like Barehano. Kadira and Kadara, we have discussed, that is the two types of Kadira. Kadira, that is Acacia Catechu, and Kadara, that is Acacia Sumo, types of Kadira. Shweta Kadira, we used to say, sometimes Sumo Valkar also they used to compare. Okay? Acacia Catechu, Acacia Sumo, Kadira and Kadara. Then Ashwakarna, which is also belongs to one of the Terminalia species. Ashwakarna and Ajakarna and the other three drugs like Arimeda, Asana and Arjuna. Arimeda that is also belongs to the Fabaceae familiar drugs, that is Acacia species. Acacia farnesiana and Arjuna and Asana. Terminalia, Arjuna and Asana. So in while explaining about Acharya, Udarada Prashamana Mahakashaya, they have given Asana is the Pterocarpus marsupium. Some texts they have given the botanical source as Pterocarpus marsupium. Okay, so this is what Acharya has mentioned under Udarada Prashamana Mahakashaya. Next, we'll move to the Pariyaya, synonyms of Bijaka. Based on the availability, Shauri. That is the area or the place where this plant is abundantly available. Shauri. Shure Shurashena Pradeshe Bavaha. Shure Shurashena Pradeshe. That is the area. Surashena Pradesha. In that particular area, this plant is abundantly available. That is the natural source. In that particular area only, this plant will be more. Even actually, so throughout India, especially in the hilly areas, we are getting, but mainly it is abundantly available in Surashena Pradesha. Next, Pivaraha, that is Stulakandatvat. Pivaraha, Stulakandatvat. As I think we have seen in Sirsi, there is a big plant where when you cut the plant, you will get a niryasa, which is red in color. There we used to say is like the asana, they used to say, is, which is about more than 80 to 100 feet height. Even the stem is also more than 1 to 2 meter. The girth of the stem, that is sthula kandatva. The girth will be bigger, that is more girth. Even more than 2 meter also. I think we have seen in Sirisi, this plant, there is a big plant. Stula kandatva. The diameter of the main stem, the trunk, will be bigger in size. Stula kandatva. And Bandhuka Pushpi. If you see the flowers, you will come to know that. How it looks like a Bandhuk. They used to say Bandhuka Pushpi. Not actually the fruit flowers. The fruits are resembles as like that of like Bandhuka. Banduka Pushpi. Mahasarja. See, we have discussed Nadisarja. So Nadisarja is a synonym of Nadisarja Chakirtitaha. Indradru Vira Rukshashta Virascha Dabala Smrutaha. That is Kakubaha Arjuna Namakyo Nadisarja Chakirtitaha. So Nadisarja is a synonym of Arjuna. There is a Mahasarja. That is Mahan Rukshaha Sarjakaraha. Mahan Rukshaha Sarjakarha. So this, the Bijaka, which looks like that of Sarja plant. Mahan Rukshaha, that is, it is a big tree and which resembles or which looks like Sarjakarha. How the Sarja plant will be present, in the same way the Bijaka plant will be present. Okay? Mahan Rukshaha Sarjakarha. Mahan Rukshaha, it is a very big tree which resembles or which looks like the Sarja plants. Sarjakaraha. Sarja is Vetaria indica. Sarja is Vetaria indica. So how the Sarja plant will be present, in the same way the Bijaka plants also is present. Okay. So in case of Nadisarja, we used to say the Arjuna is a unknown drug, whereas the Sarja is a known drug. So Sarja plant, that is Arjuna plant, will be known through by Sarja plant. The plants which grows on the banks of the rivers and which looks like the Sarja plant. that is Arjuna. Here it is a very big tree, Mahan Rukshaha, and which resembles or which looks like Sarja plant, that is Vetaria indica. Okay, Mahasarja. So based on the availability, Shauri. So based on the main trunk, because the trunk will be bigger in size, that is Sthulakandatvat, that is Pivaraha, is the synonym of the Bijaka. Based on the fruits, Bandhuka Pushpi. And based on the comparison, Mahasarjaha. Okay, so next, as the useful part, that is the Kandasara useful part, based on the color of the Kandasara, they used to give the synonym Pitasaraha, Pitavarnaha, Sarovashaha. How the Sara is present? What may be the color? Pitavarnaha. That is yellowish color, the heartwood, the Niryasa, which is having yellowish in color. Pitasaraha, Pitavarnaha, Sarovashaha. The heartwood or the Kandasara is the useful part, which is having yellowish in color. Okay, that is called as Pitasaraha. Then Pita Shalakaha. Pita Saraha Sala Sadrushaha. Sala Sadrushaha. That is, the heartwood is yellow in color and resembles the heartwood of Shala. I think this plant also we have seen. That is Shorya Robusta. You have collected this plant in the Sirisi. So while in the field visit, we have collected the Shala plant. That is Shorya Robusta. Sala Sadrushaha. How the heartwood of Bijaka will be present? That is, the Bijaka heartwood is as like that of Shala plant, the Shala heartwood. In those days, the Shala, Sarja are the well-known plants. So this Bijaka, Arjuna are unknown plants. So the unknown plant will be known through by the Prasiddha Vastus. The Prasiddha Vastus like the Shala and Sarja. Okay. The Bijaka heartwood, how it is present? It is present as like that of the Shala, Shala Sadrushaha. How the Shala heartwood is present, in the same way the Bijaka heartwood will be present. Okay, Pita Saraha Shala Sadrushaha. That is called as Pita Shalakaha. Then Tishyaha. I think already we have come across with this word while explaining about Amalaki. The synonyms based on the flowering season. It is having Tishyafala. The Amalaki is having the synonym as Tishyafala. This is Tishyaha. Tishye Pushyamashe Pushpayati. Tishye Pushpamashe Pushyayati. That the flowering season during the Pushyamasha. The flowering will occur during the Pushyamasha. That is called as Tishyaha. Based on the order, Sugandhi. Pushpanam Sugandhitvat. Here the flowers are having aromatic in nature. The flowers are having aromatic in nature. Sugandhihi. Sugandhihi Pushpanam Sugandhitvat. That is, the flowers are having aromatic in nature. Karshaha. Based on the karma. So this is the synonym. Karshaha. Krushatva Janakaha. The plants, one which does the emaciation, one which reduces the body weight. Karshaha, one which makes the person emaciation, one which makes the person thin. So definitely you can use like the Saulya conditions. Okay, definitely in case of Medhavikaras, you can use this drug. Karshaha, based on the karma, it is having the synonym as Karshaha, Kushatva Janakaha. Okay, so next we'll move to about the Swarupa. The Swarupa of the plant Bijaka. So what you are observing this in this slide, this is leaf, the branches. So this is the one leaf. This is one leaf. I will show another picture. Huh. In this picture, it will be clear. So this is the main stalk, or you can say the petiole. So these are the leaflets. Because if you observe, if you consider this is the branch, so there is no axillary bud here. If the axillary bud will be present, then it becomes one complete leaf. So as the axillary bud is absent, then we used to consider it as a whole leaf. Okay, so the whole leaf is dissecting and dividing into forms a separate leaflets. It is going to form separate leaflets. So these are called the leaflets for the medicinal purpose. Okay, and also apart from that, they used to cut the main trunk and they used to remove the sapwood, and then they used to collect the heartwood. From that they used to distillate, and they used to collect the sara, they used to collect even the bijaka sara also. Okay, the same method, please remember this. You can how they used to collect. Okay, so this is about the fruit, how the fruits are present. That is called like a banduka pushpe. Actually, that is the banduka, the fruits are which resembles like banduka. That is banduka pushpe. They used to give the synonym. So see the main trunk, how there is girth. It is more than 2.5 meter, the girth of the main trunk. See this Pterocarpus marsupium, a protected species, triggered biodiversity conservation in community forestry in Nepal. See, this plant is also available in Nepal, Himalayan region, even the China, the Pakistan area. So there, all there in areas, this plant is naturally available. Okay. A study in Kanchanapur district in Nepal. They are conducting the studies. So these are the fruits of bijaka. Okay. About the inflorescence, it is a terminal panicle inflorescence. The inflorescence is terminal panicle inflorescence. It is a type of raceme inflorescence. Type of raceme inflorescence. You can see. So this is the main branch. So over that, the main peduncle, over that another branches they used to develop. Over that the flowers are developed. Such type of the character we used to call it, and that is older flowers at the base, younger flowers towards the apex. So based on these character we used to call it as a type of panicle inflorescence. So panicle is a type of raceme inflorescence. Okay, so type of inflorescence is, that is panicle, terminal panicle inflorescence. Even you can observe the axillary also. From the axillary region, the main peduncle they used to develop. So terminal are also axillary panicle inflorescence. The flowers are pale yellowish in color. The petals are 1 to 1.5 centimeter longer. Okay, petals are 1 to 1.5 centimeter longer. About the fruit. So type of fruit is pod, as the drug which is belongs to the Fabaceae family. The characteristic feature of Fabaceae family, the fruits are, nature of fruit is pod. Okay, and shape is nearly circular round with the wings. That is Pterocarpus. Pteron means winged, carpus means fruit. That is winged fruit. Okay, nearly circular but with wings. Size, there is the diameter 2.5 to 5 cm in diameter. Diameter of the fruit is 2.5 to 5 cm in diameter, and seed will be present. The seed will be small, that the whole seed is covered by that leathery, the wing like structure. Okay, the seed will be predominant in the fruit. Next, the useful part of the drug is heartwood. Okay, so the heartwood pieces will be rectangular or square. So this is what we are getting in the market. What we are getting in the market, the samples of the Kandasara, the heartwood of bijaka, that is the Pterocarpus marsupium, they are rectangular or square shaped, and 2 to 3 cm thickness will be present, and surface is yellowish red in color with golden hue, and marketed with the dark streaks and parallelly running striations which represent the annual rings. Okay, next, utpatti sthana. So distributed throughout India, especially in hilly areas, this plant, this Pterocarpus marsupium, Pterocarpus centellinus, Terminalia arjuna, Terminalia tomentosa, so all the these drugs are distributed throughout India, but specifically in hilly areas. Okay, so commonly seen in Karnataka, Uttar Pradesh. So that what the name they have given, shauri, based on the availability of the bijaka, is one of the synonyms having shauri. Shura, shura shena pradeshe upalabhyatva, that is the plant which is abundantly available in shura shena pradesha, that is actually Uttar Pradesh. So for Uttar Pradesh they used to call it as shura shena pradesha. Okay, and even the Bihar, Orissa, Gujarat and Madhya Pradesh. So throughout India this plant is available. especially in hilly areas. Okay. So next we'll move to the active principles. There is phytoconstituents, the chemical composition. As the vernacular name in English is called Indian kino tree. Okay, Indian kino tree. So quinotannic acid. Quinotannic acid is one of the important active principle which is present in this bijaka and also in asana also. There is terminally tomentosa. There also it contains quinotannic acid. Okay. Quino heartwood contains. Quino heartwood contains 70 to 80% of quinotannic acid. 70 to 80% of quinotannic acid. And quino red. K-phyrocatechin. K-phyrocatechin, that is catechol. And resin, gallic acid. Okay, so please remember quinotannic acid, the major active principle which is present in the bijaka, also in asana. 70 to 80% of quinotannic acid is present in the heartwood. So these are the some of the shlokas. Bijakaha, katukaha, shoshna, kashayaha, kamapittapaha, twachaha, kesho, ashrapittagnaha, krimi, visarpanashanaha, hanti, kushta, kuda, kudaschit, ramedho, meha, meha, rasayanaha. So there are, according to Kaidev Nigantu, according to Dhanvantri Nigantu, according to Bhavprakash Nigantu, there are different, say like asanaha, kaduru, ushnahascha, tikto, vata, vatarthi, doshanut. According to Rajanigantu, some acharyas, even Bhavprakash Nigantu has given the synonym for bijaka, for he used to give the synonym as asana. Okay, the common properties of bijaka as well as asana. Bijaka as well as asana. Kashaya rasa, lagruksha guna, katu vipaka, ushna virya. See, we have you can recollect the properties of Arjuna. Arjuna is also having the properties, that is Sheeta Virya. Almost Kashayarsha, Lagurukshaguna, Sheeta Virya, Katuvipaka, and Kafavata Shamaka. But here, except the Virya, even some Acharya says even the Bijaka as well as Ashaka is also having Sheeta Viryas. But most of the Nigantakaras they used to mention as Ushna Virya. Most of the Nigantakaras they used to mention it as Ushna Virya. Some Acharyas, that is especially Acharya Priyavrat Sharma. Acharya Priyavrat Sharma, he used to consider the virya of bijaka as well as asana is having Sheeta Virya. But most of the Nigantukaras, like Bhavprakash Nigantu, Yuvaraja Nigantu, Kalideva Nigantu, they used to consider they are all as Ushna Virya. The virya of bijaka and asana are they used to consider as Ushna Virya. But Priyavrat Sharma, in his Nigantus, that is in Priya Nigantu, he used to say about Sheeta Virya. Okay? So Kashaya Rasa, Lagurukshya Guna, Ushna Virya, Katu Vipaka, and Kafavata, Kshamaka. These are the common properties. Next, we'll move to the karma. So while rating the karma of asana or bijaka, the first and foremost, the important karma is Pramehagna. So Acharya Shushruta mainly highlighted the utility of bijaka and asana in case of the prameha. In case of prameha. So it is having pramehagna karma. So that's why it is indicated in case of prameha. Then it is having kushtagna karma. So indicated in case of kushta. As in case of udartha prashamana mahakashaya. There if you see the udartha prashamana dravyas. Udartha prashamana dravyas. That is tinduka, priyala, badara, kadira, khadara. In Udartha Prashamana Mahakashaya also it contains the drugs like Kadira. Kadira ha Kushtagnanam Sreshtam. Kadara, a type of Kadira. It contains Ashvakarana, Gajakarana. Then he used to mention about like Arimeda, Asana, Arjuna. Okay, so there also these drugs they are together. That is Bijaka, Asana, Kadira. They are also useful in case of the Tvak Vikaras. Okay? Kushtagna Karma. So indicating case of Kushta is having Tvaksha. As already mentioned while discussing about the Kandugna Mahakashayas. So Kandugna Mahakashaya, that Dravyas are having, that is Kandu is because of the Kapha Adikyata. And that the vitiated Kapha which takes Ashraya in Tvacha. which takes ashray in the twacha, and there it produces the symptoms like the itching sensation. So that's why the kandukna dravyas are, this udarta prashamana dravyas are also having twacha, that is useful in case of twak vikaras. Okay, and also svitragna karma, useful in case of svitra, and visarpahara, so indicating case of visarpa, rakta vikarahara, rakta shodhaka karma, so indicating case of raktaja vikaras, and it is having rakta pittagna karma, so indicating case of rakta pitta, medohara, as one of the synonym of the bijaka, is, that is karshaha. Karshaha is the synonym of bijaka based on the karma, that is prushatva janakaha, one which makes the person into emaciation, that is emaciation, or a thin, lean person, because as it does medodhatu shoshana karma, it does medodhatu shoshana karma, by that it makes the person into thin, that is medohara. And galadoshahara, that is useful in case of galarogas, that is throat disorders. Okay, so this is one of the journal. Diabetes mein fayde mein hota hai, that Vijayasara. Vijayasara is, they used to give the synonym for Bijaka. Next we'll move to Amayika Prayoga, therapeutic use. In case of Prameha, the Kwata prepared from Salasara the Gana. So as Acharya Charaka, Sushruta mentioned this Bijaka under Salasara the Gana. Sala, Saradi Gana, Sarada is Surya Roposhta. So under this Gana, Bijaka is a Bijaka Asana, or one of the drugs which is mentioned under this Salasaradi Gana. So whatever the drugs which are mentioned under Salasaradi Gana, all the drugs you can use for, by using that you can prepare the Kwata. So that Kwata is indicated in case of Prameha, which is useful, which controls even the single drug therapy. Even the single drug therapy also, there are so many research activities which are carried out on the Prameha. So Vijayasara, Rasanasara, Ashanadi Kashaya, so they are all, they used to control the sugar level in the blood. All the reports shows that, which controls the sugar level blood. Even most of the peoples, they have left the modern medicines, only they are taking the Ashanadi Kashayas, like such type of preparations. They used to control the sugar level in the blood. Okay, next, in case of Kushta, yata sarvani kushtani hataha kadira bijakau, in Shushruta Samhita Chikitsasthana 38th chapter, yata sarvani kushtani hataha, so all types of kushta will be cured by using kadira bijaka. Kadira bijaka, kadira is one of the best medicine. Along with that you can use even the bijaka is also. Okay, kadira bijakau yata sarvani kushtani hataha kadira bijakau. So Shushruta advocates uses of Kadira, Bijaka in different forms, so which will be useful in curing the different types of Kushtas. In case of Rakta Pitta, that is Kshara prepared from Asana and Madhuka. See, this is not Yashti Madhu, Glycera is a glabra. It is not Yashti, Glycera is a glabra. This is Madhuka Indica, Asana and Madhuka Indica. That is Pterocarpus Marsupium and Madhuka Indica. So these are useful in case of Rakta Pitta. The Kshara prepared from the terminally, that is Pterocarpus Marsupium and Madhuka Indica, is useful in case of Rakta Pitta. As it is having Svitragna Karma, it take off the Brungaraja, that is Eclipta Alba. Brungaraja fried in oil, kept in iron vessel, followed by milk processed with Bijaka, will cure the Svitra. So first you can take the Brungaraja. The Brungaraja useful part is the Panchanga. The whole part of the Brungaraja, that is Eclipta Alba, you can collect the Panchangas. So you can fry the this collected Brungaraja. First you can cleanly wash it. Then after completely drying, you can wash, you can fry it in a, with the Gruta. Gruta Barjana, you can do the Barjana. Then you can keep it in a iron vessel after the Barjana, and so by using that and the milk is processed with the Bijaka, so you can take that the Brungaraja, which is Barjana with the Gruta Adathaila, followed by you can take the bijaka, which is processed with the dugda. So definitely, which will cure the shvitra. Okay, there are two drugs, the important drugs. One is Bhrungaraja, another one is bijaka. So like, you can prepare a vegetable. You can prepare a vegetable by using the Bhrungaraja. So Bhrungaraja, after collecting the Bhrungaraja, you can cleanly wash it, and after completely drying the fresh the Bhrungaraja, you can do the barjana with the taila or the gruta. Okay, so after you can keep it in one vessel, then you can take the bijaka, that's the heartwood, kandasara. So that by using that kandasara, you can process with the dugda, do the samskara. You can add that bijaka in the milk. You can process, you can churn, you can mix it properly. After mixing, so you can take, you can eat that Bhrungaraja. Then you can, followed by the intake of dugda, is useful in case of shvitra. Okay, next, for drushti balartha, that is to improve the eyesight, that is like the chakshushya karma. Drushti balartha, to improve the eyesight, the oil prepared from thila, bibitaki, Bhrungaraja swarasa, asanakvata in an iron vessel used as a nashya will improve the eyesight. Okay, so what you have to do? So first, you can take the drugs. You can collect the raw drugs like thila, bibitaki, Bhrungaraja, asana. Okay, so you keep it in one side. So thila, bibitaki. Okay, you take dravadravya like Bhrungaraja swarasa. You can collect and you can prepare the from the asana. You can prepare the kvata. So asana kvata. In that you can add Bhrungaraja swarasa, then you can add the thila, kalka, and bibitaki churna. You can, from these, by using these, you can prepare the thaila in an iron vessel. So you can prepare the, after completely preparing the, after observing the thaila siddhi lakshana, you can take it out and you can preserve in a well container. So from that thaila, we used to prepare, do the nashya karma. So by doing the rashya karma, which will improve the eyesight. Okay, that is for drushti balartha. So this is one of the preparations, Pterocarpus marsupium, that is Indian kino tree. That is Vijayasara churnas. Okay, so useful part, kandasara, heartwood. Heartwood is the useful part. Next, matra, churna 3 to 6 gram. Kvata 50 to 100 ml. Depending upon the condition, you can use the kvata, you can reduce the doses. Vishishta Yoga, Asanadi Kashaya, Asanadi Kvata. Why they have given the synonym? Because Bijaka is also having the synonym as Asana. So that's why almost all the preparations are with the same name. Asanadi Kashaya, Asanadi Kvata, Asana Bilvadi Thaila, Ayashkruti. That what we have discussed for Drushti Balartha. In iron vessel, what we are preparing the thaila. Okay, Ayashkriti, Asanadi Yoga. These are some of the important the yogas. Yes, so what you are observing, this is the tree of Terminalia tomentosa. So Terminalia tomentosa, there is Asana and Pterocarpus marsupium. Both are big tree. Both are big tree. So what are the difference between Asana and the bijaka? So I am going to show some of the pictures. So the basonym of asana, ashyati kshipati pramehadin rogan, ashyati kshipati pramehadin rogan, or ashyante vikiryante phalanicha sapakshatvat, sapakshatvat. So you can remember anyone. Ashyati kshipati pramehadin rogan, one which cures the pramehadi rogas, that is called as asana. Ashyati kshipati pramehadin rogan. Okay, and another one is ashyante vikiryante phalani, the fruits, as it is a very big tree, so which covers most of the areas. So anyway, the branches which covers the most of the areas, the fruits of the that particular plant which will spread the almost the most of the areas, which covers the large areas, that which explains about the second, the basonym. Okay, so Terminalia tomentosa. Terminalia tomentosa is the botanical source for Asanum, which is belongs to Combretaceae family. Vernacular names: Indian laurel tree. Indian laurel tree. Kannadalli matti gida. Kannadalli matti gida. Hindiyalli asan. Hindiyalli asan. Okay. So Indian kino tree is the English name for bijaka, and Kannadalli matti gida for this Terminalia tomentosa asana. Okay. Next. This is also Udartha Prashamana Mahakashaya and Sala Saradi Gana. We'll see the difference. See, in this picture, you can observe leaves. So leaves are simple leaves, whereas in case of Bijaka, that is imperipinnately unipinnate compound leaves. This is simple leaf. Okay, in this picture, you can clearly observe. So, and also we have this. In our garden, this plant is also present. Asana, Bijaka, both are present. So you can observe, so this is a type of simple leaves. As I have mentioned in the Terminalia species, like Terminalia chebula, Terminalia bellerica, Terminalia arjunum. So one of the important characteristic feature to distinguish, you can easily identify the drugs, the presence of the glands. So in case of Terminalia chebula, there are two glands are present at the base of the petiole, sorry, base of the apex, base of the lamina, or the apex of the petiole. There are two glands will be present. Where in case of Arjuna, these glands are present in the lower part of the apex of the petiole, apex of the petiole or the base of the lamina. But in case of the Terminalia tomentosa, so these glands are present here. If it is possible, you can observe. So very specific the arrangement. So the glands will be present here. So you can observe. The glands will be present here. Okay, so this is a type of leaf is simple. Arrangement is opposite or sub-opposite. The arrangement of leaf is opposite or sub-opposite will be present. So in this picture you can clearly observe. See, there are two glands which are present in the lower surface of the, in the middle of the lamina. So here you can observe the two glands. So this is a Terminalia tomentosa. Okay, so in case of Arjuna, the glands are present at the base. So this is about the inflorescence. So like the Terminalia chebula, Terminalia bellerica, the same type of inflorescence will be present in case of this Terminalia tomentosa also. That is a type of raceme inflorescence. Okay, that is in case of terminal panicle inflorescence, axillary or panicle inflorescence. Here, this is a spike inflorescence, type of raceme inflorescence. You can observe the fruits. So these are the fruits. You can observe the type of fruits. So as you are, you can observe even the Arjuna also, the same, like winged fruit. Winged fruit will be present. This is another picture. Okay, so there is an, in the last month, I think in the May 24-25, there is an, one news came in the Times of India and Deccan Herald. So the Terminalia tomentosa plant, you can observe some pictures. So when you take the incision, when you make an incision over the plant, over the tree, so the water will come. So some more pictures I will show you. See, in this picture, you can clearly observe. Here, the water is coming out from that plant when you make an incision. This is the Terminalia tomentosa plant. You can go through the in the net, you can observe. So what may be the reason? So what may be the cause for such type of, how it stores the water? You will get detailed information in the Times of India, and also you can go through the YouTube also, they have uploaded these pictures. This is a Terminalia tomentosa plant. And this Terminalia tomentosa also, they used to give the botanical source like Terminalia alata, Terminalia elliptica. They are synonyms for Terminalia tomentosa. Okay. So this is about Bijaka as well as the Asana. Okay. So by this, I want to conclude that today's topic. Thank you.